Hey there. So it's been a hot minute since I made an inverted triangle video, and it is because I've been doing some experimenting with body shapes. I'm changing my inverted triangle body shape. Maybe not fully, but I am working with it to bend to my will. Let me explain. I just have to note that I'm not here to encourage you to dislike being an inverted triangle body shape. I'm here to tell you that your body shape is beautiful as is, and it's more versatile than you think. The purpose of this video is to show you that you can do way more things with an inverted triangle body shape than you think. As an inverted triangle body shape who has an in-shape look, I would like to say that I think it's a pretty sexy shape. Why? It's because we kind of have a cheat. We have that upper body build that is associated with sexy fit physiques, and we already have it. Meanwhile, there's others out there that are lifting and lifting and lifting, trying to build and have the look that we have. Trust me, this body shape is not that bad. On to my explanation. Our body shape is wide, narrow, narrower, hence why it's a triangle that's upside down. Maybe you want that wide, narrow, and then wide shape. You know, it kind of gives that curvy look. With being an inverted triangle, remember, as I mentioned in a previous video, it's about bone structure. So there's no changing that. But what I did learn is that you can change other things by making them bigger or by cinching. You can make your waist smaller individually and at the same time do exercises that will build your bottom half. Not just your booty, but your whole bottom half. So legs, calves included, and quads. It's pretty much set in stone that we'll have a wide upper part no matter what. Welcome to inverted triangle life. But you can change the other things and you can still be curvy. Keep those shoulders, sis, because you can still have that nice feminine look and still have that upper part that's a bit bigger, and it's okay. It's all about playing with proportions. Many of us may want this curvy look because of social media and just that generic look of wanting to be curvy and feminine. And hey, that's okay. I don't judge. I'm just calling it for what it is. If that's what you want, then that's totally okay. So, a little on waist training for me. Throw back with me. Back when I was 19, that's when I first started waist training, and I wore it to work, I wore it to work out, and it would be long hours I would wear it, which I don't recommend exercising in it or wearing it past 8 hours. However, this was a time when I was eating unrestricted and I was able to pack on some serious muscle because I was lifting heavy and my diet wasn't restricted. So it was giving me a really dramatic look. So come 2020/2021, I am much smaller. I was wondering if I could still have that dramatic effect even though my body shape's a bit smaller. And it turns out, yes, I can totally do it. And it's definitely something I recommend for inverted triangles in general, because it gives you flattering, very beautiful curves without having to do surgery. Waist training paired with proper diet. I cannot stress the importance of this trio. If you leave off one of them, then the other doesn't work. Like, it all needs to happen at the same time. You need to make sure that you balance diet, exercise, and waist training, and you will see the results that you need to see. Even waist training in itself has some tips and tricks and do's and don'ts that should be understood. So before you start waist training, please, please, please look into how to waist train, what waist trainer to get, and so on and so forth. My biggest takeaway for you guys here is no matter what, when you exercise, your body changes, and even changing your diet too. So just starting with those two things in general will make your body change. Adding in a waist trainer just adds in that extra oomph. It's the cherry on top for that nice feminine curvy look that a lot of us desire. So even right now I'm wearing a waist trainer. It's very easy to wear it throughout the day, so long as you purchase one that is your correct size. It should feel like a tight hug, but it should never be like super uncomfortable. So you can see. And it's given me some great results so far. So I do recommend it for you. And if you'd like some guidance, I would definitely love to share some videos, some tips and tricks that I've learned about waist training over the years. Also, don't forget waist training, fitness, and anything that has to do with slow and steady change is a journey. And you're not gonna see results if you start to feel impatient or feel as though results aren't coming. They are coming. You just need to stick with it. It'll come, promise. And when you do get to the goal, don't forget, maintenance is key to keeping this body shape. And remember, these aren't like permanent things. Your body can bounce back. It's like a rubber band. It'll snap right back if you don't do anything with it. So just to keep that in mind. So I can definitely share my waist training journey with you guys in another video. Comment down below if you'd like to see something like that, or if you have any specific questions about it as I'm making the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. I definitely did not expect for an inverted triangle community to grow, but because of you, I'm able to have a platform and I am so grateful for it. Don't forget to like this video if you like it. Comment down below if you have any questions at all. And if you are new, don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, see ya. Bye.